We're getting back into court shape after a prolonged layoff. Welcome back to Street Ball Strategies. On your metabolism, there ain't no antidote to analyze a known fact. Hip hop fanatics take the dope so they're the hip hop Prozac. Test the lyricist steady blazing. Half man, half amazing. So this topic comes up for a couple of reasons. One is because I just joined my local gym after about 20 years or so of staying away. That way I could continue to get court time throughout the winter. Usually winter is a bulking time for me. Not so much time spent on the court, you know, being an outdoor street ball player. So I had the opportunity, so I figured I'd join my local gym, stay on the court for the winter, stay in shape. And I haven't done that in 20 years, so now I have to adjust to being in basketball shape in the winter for the first time in a long time. Currently, while making this video, how do we put this for the YouTube algorithm? I have the worldwide virus, right? The virus that's been going around. I have it right now. It's in me. It's in me. Help. No, I'm fine, but I have been off the court. I haven't been doing any kind of training whatsoever for the last 2 weeks. That includes my nutrition and the way I eat. Even that has been steeply affected over the last 2 weeks. Going from working out every day, being on the basketball court every day, even in November in Michigan, to having this 2 weeks off, now I have to get back into shape. So I thought we would talk about how to do it as efficiently as possible. In terms of the mechanics of how you're gonna go about doing this as efficiently as possible, they're gonna remain the same in terms of whatever you did to get into court shape in the first place. That's what you're gonna do again to get back into court shape. But when we're talking about making that as quick and efficient as possible, we need to start with knowing our bodies. It's easy to evaluate yourself and your body when you feel good, when you feel well. But those are the times when you should be pushing yourself to your limits to try to figure out what you're capable of doing, where your ceiling is, and how and if you can push yourself beyond that. But it is when you're not feeling quite 100% when you really grow to know and understand your body. When you're tired, when you feel a little under the weather, when you're sore, when you feel like you just don't have it for that day. Those are the instances where you really get to understand what your body does under those kind of conditions. And it's important that you test yourself in those adverse conditions so you know how your body reacts to being under that kind of pressure and that kind of stress. Because for those of you young players who haven't had to have long periods of time away from the game yet that are imposed against your own will, you don't know what it's like to come back from those long absences. So the best you can do to that point is to really know and understand your body, how it performs when you feel good, how it performs when you feel poorly. That will set the foundation for how it's going to react when it comes to circumstances where you're away from the game for a long period of time and having to make a comeback. Secondly, getting to know your body is completely dependent upon you listening to your body. What your body needs in order to operate and perform the way you want it to. You've probably heard that said before that you should listen to your body, and if you're younger, you probably subscribe to the notion that you don't really need to listen to your body because it'll always just do what you tell it to do. And while that is true to a degree, there's obviously times where you're going to need to rest, where it's a must-do situation instead of forcing yourself to perform when you are not ready to do so. So while listening to your body is very fundamental and simple, it can become convoluted if we let it, because as basketball players, as competitors, when we are trying to decide whether we should rest or whether we should perform, while it should be as simple as listening to your body, it's our emotions, it's our ego that can get in the way and cloud our judgment. Because as players, as competitors, we always want to play. We always want to compete. We always want to go out and prove ourselves. Even if it's only to prove to ourselves that we can overcome whatever adversity we're going through and still perform well out on the court. But there are going to be times when it's going to be very questionable whether or not you should actually perform whatever activity you have planned for that day, or if you should indeed rest. So let's talk about the best way you can learn to listen to your body. I have a fairly straightforward, simple rule when it comes to determining whether or not I should rest and how to listen to my body. And it starts with being able to give your body a chance to actually talk to you so that you can listen. The way you do this is usually by going out there and trying whatever it is that you had planned for that day. So whether it's playing a game or just practicing or training, whatever it may be, go out, give it a try, really see what your body is capable of for that circumstance on that day, and see whether or not it's going to perform well enough for you to continue or not. The safe thing to do would always just to be to rest whenever you feel on the fence about whether or not you should play, perform, train, whatever it is for that day. But I feel as though, unless you're sure that you should be resting, you should always give whatever you have planned for that day. You should give it a try and see how it goes. So give your body a chance to actually speak to you before you decide to just take the day off. Your decision should always be based on whether or not you actually enjoy what you're going to be doing that day. If you start whatever activity it is, if it's just training and you start training and you feel like garbage and it feels terrible and it's just torturous, then obviously that should be a sign that you don't need to do that for that day. I frequently talk about your love for the game on this channel because I think enjoyment is at the root of why we do all of this, especially out here at the park where there is no awards and there's, you know, it's not an actual career you're building, it's just, you know, your own personal legacy. So enjoyment should be at the root of why we do everything we do. And when you're trying to decide if it should be a rest day or not, try whatever it is that you have planned for that day and see whether or not you can get through it with some kind of enjoyment, some kind of satisfaction. If you start something and it feels okay and you can, a lot of times you will surprise yourself as to how well you'll actually complete that given task for that given day. When you make that decision of, okay, I don't really feel like doing X, Y, and Z today, but I'm gonna give it a try, see how it goes, see how I feel, and then you discover that you are capable of completing that, and then you do complete it, even if you don't do it to your highest potential for that particular day, you'll come away from that day still feeling good, still feeling accomplished because you did something when it would have been easier for you to just give up and take that day off. That's what I'm talking about when I say your decision should be based upon your enjoyment of what you're doing for that day. So you put those three elements together, knowing your body, listening to your body, and then having your decision of whether or not you're going to rest for that day based on enjoyment. That's what I'm talking about when I say getting back into court shape and doing it as efficiently as possible. You're always going to do the same things you did to get into shape in the first place. That's what you're going to do to get back into shape. But it's a matter of how fast and efficiently can you do it. And if you try to do too much too soon, if you push your body too hard too soon before it's ready, you're going to add on way more additional time than you should have when it comes to getting back into shape. And then if you rest too much, then that as well is wasted time. So know your body, listen to your body in order to know your body, and then base your resting decisions upon whether or not you're getting enjoyment out of trying to push yourself when you don't really feel like it. So thank you guys for watching. It's a weird time, a weird video. I'm pretty much all healthy. I just have a couple days left before I'm able to really get back to the gym and start working my way back in. But if you found this video helpful, that's great. Make sure you give me a thumbs up. And also make sure you subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of my future videos. Speaking of not missing any future videos, make sure you hit that notification bell so that you are sure to get notified of every video I post. So thank you guys again, and I will see you guys next week. When the mic's on, I'm like a python to the rhythm. Pointing to your system, my saliva be the venom. Lyric like acid when I spit them. They eating through your denim. Jeans, khakis, no matter what the size. Want to bust through the way, new empty that survives. You try, but then I make them scream. Burning through their system, now they're just sitting in their bloodstream. You try to front and act like you never heard of me. I'll be the one sending MC to surgery. A diagnosis that you might need Kaiser. Penetrate your body as the party gets lava. I'll make your heart stop with the blood clot. Killing wax and seeds in the name of hip hop. Never go pop, cause pop be the weasel. Just a lyricist, lyrically.